October is the month of establishing momentum in every way possible here. For example, today it was shown to me that time to start a diet, so I literally started it today, boom, like that. Sometimes you have to tear yourself away, pull yourself away from old habits and start new ones, and October is the time to do that. Whatever it is, just say, okay, hey, time to go for it. Time to go for it, because the events are going to happen now nonstop, nonstop surprises and situations that are going to try and activate us into action and try to deepen our delusion and our unawareness that we're dreaming, and the fact that what we need to do is to wake up. Everything will be trying to attract us away from that. So we have to start establishing momentum in directions that are helpful for us in this month. So now's the time. It'll come up to you. It happened to me very amazingly. I just suddenly, the idea popped into my mind, hey, I need to start a diet. I go somewhere and somebody suddenly starts talking about something, some food they made, and that they're on this diet, and they start explaining it to me and talking, and I say, huh, that sounds very interesting. I think I'll try that. Gave me exactly what I needed to do, just like that. So in every way, start good habits, start momentum right now. Don't wait until November. It's too late then. Start your good habits, your momentum this month, right now. And the good habits you have, continue on. For instance, right now, there are a couple of baseball games here in the Bay Area that are very, very pivotal, and I've been watching them and following them closely, and they're right at, you know, coming up to the end of the games, and I said, hey, you know what? Time to tape. So pulled myself away from that. Forget it. It's way more important right now to start establishing momentum. Make hay while the sun shines. Has never been more appropriate than right now. This is literally, October is the pivotal month. Forget about December or November. You know, December 2012, forget about it. That's not the pivotal month. October 2012 is the pivotal month. Because it's the month, it's our last chance to start the momentum going. Okay? Get the momentum going. It'll be too late in November, December to get momentum going. We will be gripped by events, and those events will be driving us into some sort of action, some sort of activism, action, efforts for an outcome, consequences. We'll be desperately struggling with that. But if we have the good habits, the momentum that we've established in October, if we have that, we will be able to ride that wave and not wipe out. You know, we'll be able to be on the surface of that, be able to float above it, as it were, glide past it. It won't be able to suck us in to that black hole of action and activism and desperate struggles to achieve outcomes. We will know exactly where we stand. We'll be in tip-top shape, and we will be able to focus on the prayer of awakening, which is the prayer to not pray for any outcomes. Not pray for any outcomes in existence. Awakening is not an outcome in existence. It means awakening from the dream of existence. So we pray that we not be praying or searching or active towards any outcome at all in existence. And that, not good outcomes, not bad outcomes. And it also means not staying with the outcome we have right now either. None of it. None of it. And we'll be able to see the world through that lens, and thereby rapidly awaken or ascend, whatever you want to call it, out of the dream. The dream evaporates from us, as it were. We're protected. The Passover principle works for us. The dream actually becomes more and more wonderful and beautiful, because the whole dynamic of the dream has to back away because it sees us as a threat, so it's trying to get really far away from us as possible. And so the positive aspect of the dream, which is just a fall guy for the negative aspect of the dream, that positive aspect will predominate for us as it waits for some sort of for the threat that we pose to it to lessen, so then the destructive aspect can come in. But since it doesn't lessen, the positive aspect simply abides with us. All that is what we have to look forward to. Don't have to pay any attention to reacting or acting on anything that happens in the world. And right now we're still able to listen to this and say, yeah, that's good advice. November, I think people will be so up in arms, so distraught, and realize that their future is not going to be what they want. And let's face it, folks, the good old days are gone. They are gone. And this November is a desperate attempt to bring back the good old days, but the good old days are irretrievably gone. And there are many people who simply cannot accept that. And of course, we know there never were any good old days here. Not really. There are no good, really, truly good days in existence at all. It's only awakening from this dream, choosing a different idea, experiencing our true identity, the I Am presence of isness. It's only by that we have a good day, a truly good day. So let us not fight to preserve the good old days, because they're already gone. And they will be so far gone soon that people who are clinging to those will not a pretty picture, to say the least. Total non-action, effortless non-action, momentum towards effortless non-action, which is, again, not praying for any particular outcome at all in existence. That is where safety lies. That is the absolute best you can do in existence. It's the only thing that really works, because it enables you to not be waiting for any outcome. You're no longer a waiter. You're no longer a waiter. Let me see. I'm going to try something as we're going along here. See if I can add a video shot that I took today. It was an amazing shot that portrays what is going to happen. And I'm going to dig into this for just one second here. Look for this video source that I took with my video camera. Let me see if I can remember which one it is. Well, that's not it. This one is going to show, you'll just have to see it because it's pretty amazing. It really shows the future, it portrays the future. And here we go. This one will give, whoa, what was that? Big insect came flying in. This will give something of it. Okay, let's try this one. Here we go. You won't be able to hear me narrate unless, yeah. So I'm just gonna play this for you. Take a look at this. This portrays kind of our future, what's going to happen as far as events and activation is concerned. Very great. There you go. That was taken just today, October 2nd. And you hear those flares, those loud explosions and the flare, and then kaboom, and all the birds suddenly get activated, right? They're sitting there on the hillside, nice and calm, and suddenly they get something, you know, startles them, and they get activated. And then another flare comes, boom, and then another, and another, and another. One after the other, and they keep being activated. Waves and waves and waves of activation. That is what is going to happen right there. Perfect example of what's going to happen. You just saw it for yourself. And the air is going to be then flooded with all this chaos up in the air, as it just, everything's wheeling and circling around. Everyone's activated. When everybody becomes activated, you have a situation that is really not good at all for your peace of mind, and for you to abide in effortless non-action and not praying for any outcomes whatsoever in existence. Very difficult at that time. So it is critical. We're at a critical time. October is the critical month. We have to establish momentum. In many ways, okay, every day you should establish in October, you should establish momentum towards a very good outcome for yourself, spiritual outcome. Even very practical ones. For instance, today, I said, you know what? It's time to shed some pounds and get down to, you know, some super optimal weight, where, you know, they're not carrying so much heaviness around. I just said, you know what? That's it. Start it today. So instead of saying, well, I'm going to do something tomorrow, in this month, say, I'm going to start it today. I'm going to start it right now. Is that it? And when I got the idea to start on a diet, I said to the Prime Creator, I said, it's a done deal. It's a done deal. I got it. It's already a done deal. Like, it's already been done. Because I realized I'm going to do it. And no struggle at all. It's a done deal already. Because I know how important it really is right now to get all good habits underway in this month. All good habits. Whatever is a good habit for you right now, get it started. I'm sure everyone has these habits that they know are good habits, and they may have been slacking off under all the stress of the times. Well, you know, right now is the perfect time to get back in those good habits and just say, draw the line. Say, okay, that's it. I cannot continue to indulge in any bad habits. I need all good habits right now. I need my entire being to be going in the right direction that puts a foundation for my ability to focus on the prayer that I not pray for any outcomes or actions or outcomes or consequences, any particular outcome at all in existence. And therefore, I will be rapidly going towards not waiting for any outcome. And when you're not waiting for any outcome in a dream, you wake up from the dream. It's the waiting, it's the expectation, it's the desire for outcomes that keep you dreaming. And with good habits, you'll be able to maintain the momentum in that direction, towards awakening instead of deepening your sleep. People have two choices right now. They can either deepen their sleep or awaken. Those are the two choices right now. There isn't much middle ground at all. I'll tell you the truth is that's evaporating. It will evaporate in this world. It will evaporate. You will not see a world where people are kind of sitting on the fence. No. Because those who want to awaken realize that if they don't, they're going to be pulled back into deeper sleep. So they're not going to sit on the fence anymore. Just forget it. No way. And the rest, the situations are such, are designed in this world to deepen one's slumbers, deepens one's unawareness that one is actually just dreaming, just imagining Just believing. That's all. Just believing in imagination. Believing in a dream. None of it's true. So certainly we don't want the dream to deepen, which means we have to go towards awakening now. There isn't any choice. And you have to get a march on the whole situation. That's a sign of spiritual awareness on your part, is to steal a march on the whole situation. Better too early than too late. Too late is too late. Okay? Too early is just right. You know, a little bit early is just right. Just right. Because you'll go into November with all these good habits, all this good orientation, all of this momentum, and you'll be riding that momentum. And then when the road gets really bumpy, you know, you will have already gone down the road. You know, when all the stuff starts collapsing on the road, you will have already gone down that road, past that point. And the road that you're on is smooth. It's still smooth. You look behind you, and the road is just absolutely being blocked, entirely blocked. That is a fact. That's what I saw in a vision, exactly what's going to happen. The road is going to be blocked. Boulders everywhere, as it were, you know, obstacles everywhere. And everybody will be frantically in action, trying to clear the road and blaming others. And, you know, it'll just be the hive will be buzzing, absolutely buzzing. But if you get on down the road ahead of time, you have smooth sailing. You have smooth sailing. And that is my determination. It has been something that I've been working on for a long time, and really in full-on emergency mode for so long, to get on down that road. The road that is paved by your momentum and your clarity, that propels you down that road fast, really fast. It hit 100 degrees here in the Bay Area today. 100 degrees. That must be some kind of record where we live. And hottest day of the year, actually. And we need to head on down the road at 100 miles an hour, you know. We need our effort to be like a 100 degree effort, a record effort towards establishing momentum to get on down that road. So when everything starts falling apart, we have a very cohesive set of good habits, right orientation, all of that, and we'll just polish it and get better and better at it. Hopefully we can make things better and better and better. But right now what we need to do is establish momentum. We'll talk about what will happen later at a later date. But October is the month of momentum. Okay, so we are focusing on momentum right now. And you definitely, it'll pop into your mind. If your intention is there, it'll pop in your mind and say, aha, that's what I need to knock that out. If I say, enough of that, that's finished with. I'm finished with that. As of this moment, I'm actually finished with that. That's it. It's easy because you know what the stakes are. When you realize this, how high the stakes are, decisions become easy. Become really, really easy. The wishy-washiness is gone. I know the hunger pangs will hit me, but I'm not even interested in them. Not even paying attention to it. It's a done deal, and I won't even, you know, think about it. It's not even important. It's like we're outrunning a storm. You know, at some point, you realize you need to outrun a storm, and you start heading away from the storm, and you go as fast as you can, and you get out of harm's way. It's like that. It's establishing this momentum now. Don't wait until the storm hits and then say, okay, what do I do? Because then, you know, everything will be jammed up and people will be the atmosphere will be terrible. Right now it's still clear enough where we can focus on this. It really is. Ordinarily, I'd be focused on the outcome of baseball games, and I say the outcomes don't matter. What matters is building momentum, sharing this information with the world, and giving the advice, the right advice. This month is for your momentum. That's not too much to ask, you know. 1 month, just to focus on establishing momentum. It's not so bad, you know. You can knock out ice cream for a month, so to speak. Right? You can let go of something for a month just to give yourself the opportunity to get momentum going. Get momentum going in every facet of your life, whatever it is. Yeah, I put my golf clubs away. Forget it, not even thinking about it, not even going to play. No way. Finish with it, at least for now. Said, nah, it's way, way too important right now. You can't be wasting time that way. This is the month of momentum. And I said, that's it. Hang them up. No more. No mas. Some later date, who knows? But for right now, it's out. It's out. You know, the diet's in. Golf is out. Outcomes in games are out. And those are just a few things. You know, everybody can find something every day. Every day we'll find something. Praying for outcomes is out, as it were. Trying to, activism is out. Action is out. Effortless inaction is in. Starting to practice that effortless inaction. In other words, we're completely indifferent to all outcomes. Whatever they may be, we see that they're all the same, they're all part of a dream. And outcomes in a dream have no meaningful distinctions. It's like they're all zero. They're all just a play of imagination. So we're detaching from all those bad habits of trying to arrive at outcomes, focusing on that. Of course, as long as you have a body in this world, all sorts of outcomes will constantly be playing. But we're not attached to it. We're not praying for certain any particular outcomes. All outcomes are seen as equally meaningless. Pragmatically, things will happen. And as we are more unattached to what happens here, more and more positive situations will actually happen. We just remain unattached to those. So you have all sorts of ways to establish good momentum right now. Have a positive outlook. Don't get pulled down by any negativity right now. That's a good... Because your positive outlook is not based on the events of existence. It's the positive outlook that there's a way to awaken from this dream, and you're going to do it. It's that positive outlook. You're confident that you're not going to get pulled into activism and desperate struggles for outcomes. Be confident of that, and be positive of that. See, that's a great, great momentum builder right there. Don't let depression or despair or anything like that creep in. It'll try, but just go right back to no. I'm on a very positive tangent. I'm a very positive direction. Very auspicious. So no reason whatsoever to despair. I'm not praying for any particular outcome at all, but I have faith that whatever outcomes appear will get better and better and better and better for me. Because I have this fundamental understanding of the entire situation of existence and how to awaken from it. And so it can't help, threat can't help but back away, because now you threaten the dream. The dream feels very threatened by you and scared and backs away, because you're the dreamer and you're the one that can end the dream, you see? And in fact, you're going to end the dream. You're going to awaken from it. You're going to overlay it. It won't disappear, it'll be overlaid. At first it'll be an overlay of unconditional love. So you're going towards very, very great situations for yourself. So when despair tries to creep in, say, "Oh, no, I'm not trying to choose any particular outcome whatsoever." And that'll release the despair and depression. It can't really creep in then. And the faith comes in where we have to have faith that by giving up any attempt to orchestrate any particular outcome in existence, not be attached to any outcome, that actually will give rise to better and better situations for you. That's the best, that is the way that it comes about. Now, from a practical standpoint, developing, you know, starting good habits is a means towards moving towards not praying for no specific outcomes. It's a means to go in that direction. So it's okay to work on that. It's okay to work on that. But work on that in an attitude also of not attachment, not attached to any outcomes. But at the same time, realizing that it's very important to give yourself the optimum opportunity to focus on not being attached to any outcomes. And in order to do that, you do have to have momentum in that direction right now. And you got to make sure that you don't get ensnared by the by that which is trying to deepen our sleep. And the events are, you know, you don't have to keep up with events. I'm not watching the news anymore. It's not important. I already know there's simply going to be one shocking event after the other that hit every segment, key segments of our culture, of our society, of all our cherished values, that is just going to essentially, it's going to be like a rigged demolition, much like World Trade Center number 7, for instance. You know, was just pulled down like that, and you know, we say, how did that possibly happen? Well, some say that it was it was a rigged demolition. Poof, 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 pop, 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 all these little pops, you know, boom, goes down just like that. Actually, the entire civilization, this planet, is been rigged in that same way. And of course, people won't see it that way. They'll think, "Oh, it just happened. How did it happen?" They don't know. It's intentionally. It's all set up. The demo teams have been in this world. The cultural demo teams have been in this world, setting up all these situations and scenarios that are going to bring the whole thing crashing down incredibly quickly, shockingly quickly, and you know, they're. Desecration of what we hold sacred will occur more and more and more and more and more, and people just let it slide, basically, and people even cheer it, you know. The barbarians will cheer the sacking of Rome, and those who have come in to demolish this civilization will certainly be cheering its demolishment. But we, again, are neither crying nor cheering. We're waking up from this dream. Our attitude is one of peaceful neutrality, non-attachment, unconcern, knowing that there are no real consequences in a dream. None. And that this whole thing about the good and the bad, it's all a setup to try and get us to believe that there are real consequences. In other words, to pull us into desperate struggle for outcomes. That just enhances our belief that it's possible for some causal effects to come in from some place outside of another causal effect and then influence that other causal effect, even destroy it, which would mean that reality can be destroyed, which is our objective in dreaming this dream of existence. That's our objective. We want to be prime creator. Therefore, we have to force the prime creator to change reality and make us prime creator. And we're trying to find a way to threaten reality so the prime creator feels threatened and must change reality for us. So we're acting out this threat here in existence. So when we believe that something in the dream is real, is being threatened. We are believing that that reality can be threatened. Now, of course, we don't have to like what's happening. That's a different thing. But we must give priority to this perfect detachment and neutral condition, and not praying for any outcome whatsoever. Not bad outcomes, not good outcomes, not outcomes of just staying the same. No outcomes. It's all zero. Have that feeling that it's all zero, equally zero, and you're not fooled by the good and the bad and the ugly all interacting in the heroes. You're not fooled by the damsel in distress. You're not paying attention to that. You're not paying attention to the wicked barbarians. You're not paying attention to the superheroes, you know, swinging through the cityscapes. You're not paying attention to any of it. It's all a zero. It's all equally a zero. It's all a setup. That's the truth. We artfully set our traps, trying to somehow empower a threat to reality by believing even more, by belief, by somehow 100% belief. We think if we just believe enough that it's possible, it will become real. And that's our delusion. In the Catholic tradition, there is the Lenten season, which is 40 days of, fasting, as it were. I think, I believe it's before Easter. And that's actually a very good tradition, because what it's really symbolizing is purification, starting good habits. They say you're supposed to start good habits. Start, you know, a period of good habits right before what? You know, before the crucifixion. What is the crucifixion? Well, it's what's going to happen to this planet. It's what's coming up very soon. It's what we would call a crucifixion. A series of events. The crucifixion is a whole series of events, which, lashings, all the lashings and the starving and the thorns, crown of thorns, you know, which are just many, many little events causing us terrible mental anguish. And then, the lashing is, again, more brutal events. And then the severe fatigue and carrying the cross and then finally being nailed to the cross and dying. That, you know, it shows you, it's a way of symbolizing what's going to happen in this world. And the Lenten season is 40 days of fasting, prayer, and purification, and starting good habits. That's exactly what this October needs to be. We don't have to put it in any particular religious context, but the same principle is the same. But this is the real crucifixion that's coming up now. The crucifixion of this cycle, the end of the cycle, on this planet, and all important that you start good habits now. That you do some, fasting, you cleanse yourself of everything that you don't really want to have going forward as the crucifixion events begin, and one after the other, all these things gradually weakening, you want to have the momentum, and you don't want anything to be pulling you into that, so you want to be very pure by the time I say the elections in November 6th. You want to be very pure by that time. So we have, essentially 36, starting October, we'd have 37 days, which is about 40 days, I actually got started a little bit before November, so it's like calling it 40 days. It's like a Lenten season, 40 days to prepare. Jesus also spent 40 days in the wilderness, something like that. I'm not sure if I have all this right, because it's not important. The principle is what's important. Is you spend that time really getting yourself in A1 condition, and always. And here we have the opportunity. Here we're staring in the face, actual situation. It's not just some hypothetical now at this point. It's in the hypo, that existence is a hypothetical itself, but within that hypothetical, these events are going to take place. And it's going to be one after the other, after the other, after the other, crown of thorns. Each one, you know, causing severe pain and bloodshed. You know, gradually weakening us, like a bullfight where you keep throwing the matador keeps, you know, throwing those, first the picadors, they throw in the little lances, and the matador keeps, you know, stabbing the bull, whatever. It weakens the bull. The bull gets more and more weak, you know, gradually. Same thing. It's going to be this weakening. And the more we react to events with anger and upset and frenzy and stuff, the weaker we're going to get. That's what they're looking for. That's what the whole dream's looking for. But if we're in a completely neutral, detached, unconcerned condition, not praying for any outcomes at all, we're literally waking up from the dream. And actually, the entire dream has to soften up, because it says, it's not getting the result it wanted. Here's some people that are not, you know, reacting to it. But what the events want you to do is to react to them. That's what they want. That's their aim. That's their objective. They want to pull you into all sorts of reaction, which gets eventually pulled into conflict, and even worse reactions, more and more violent reactions, more and more fearful, passionate, violent, hateful reactions. You know, that's the whole thing is designed to pull you into that direction where you'll become a savage. You'll do things you never thought you'd possibly do. You'll find yourself becoming what you would call extremely wicked, committing terrible, you know, atrocities. That's what it's designed to. It's designed to pull everyone into that. And then, you know, all sorts of heroic actions too, and all of these things, these stereotypes in the dream, is designed to pull you into all that stuff. The only safe position is the high indifference, the detached, unconcerned, not praying for any outcomes whatsoever. Where you, and that literally softens the dream up for you and for the whole world, and enables you to wake up, and helps the rest of the world to move closer to awakening. Not that they necessarily are going to wake up right at this point, but it'll certainly help them. But it's really possible for quite a few in this world to wake up from the dream now, because the stakes have gotten real high. All the chips are on the table. And whatever you do, don't wait until after, you know. Don't wait. Now is the time. Don't wait for January or December or November. It'll be too late. So it should be easy. It should be easy. Not a big deal. Not a problem. It's very doable. And you'll find out you have the capacity to do it. You know, you're not intimidated. You say, it's now or never. So let's do it now. Let's do it now. All right. That's enough for right now. Get your habits going. Get your momentum going now.